All right, we're back. Today we're going to be talking about points timing. This is my 1983 Harley Shovelhead FXSB. I saw some videos out there, and for those of us that need a little bit more insight, this video is going to be for us.
The tools you're going to need for this project are a flathead and Phillips head screwdriver, a 9/16 socket, feeler gauges that go to at least 18 thousandths, a 3/8 inch Allen key, and last but not least, you're going to need some sort of test light. This is my test light. You can use a bunch of different styles. Even a voltmeter will work. And that's it.
Alright, this here is your points cover plate. We're going to remove that with Phillips heads usually. Maybe you have Allen keys, doesn't really matter. Just remove it, whatever you have to do. This particular bike came with an early Harley Davidson electronic ignition. I really wasn't crazy about it. For kick-only applications, it really is terrible. It's really for a bike that has a starter on it. So I decided to put points in my bike, and I'm going to show you how to install points also. So this is the first thing. This comes off. All right, so now that your points cover's off, I'm going to assume that you're installing points for the first time. So for those of you that already have your points in place, you can skip forward, but when you buy your points assembly, it comes with your flyweights here, and in the back it has a little pin. The pin here slips into the groove here that's in the end of your cam. So what you can do is just set that in there, wait till it lines up, and then give it a good push down, and it should just pop into place. Now that that's in place, you also have a flat side here of your, this is what opens and closes your points gap. So the flat side, and then goes in, there's a little pin in your flyweights assembly, and you just make sure that it's on that side of things. So with that in place, what you want to do is take your cam bolt. Here, I prefer to put a little bit of Loctite on it. You should probably use blue. I'm using red just because that's all I have here. You're gonna put that into the end of your cam, thread it down, and use your 9/16 socket to tighten it up. If you want to torque it down, which you should do, I'm not going to, but you should. You want to torque it down. I believe the torque spec is 20 to 25 foot-pounds of torque. All right, so this is your actual points plate here. This is what's known as your condenser. This little lead coming off of your condenser goes actually onto the metal that's wrapped around here on your points plate. These are your contacts here, just to give you an idea of what you're looking at. This slips in, and then these two bolts holes here, take these guys, and they thread in there. And you can just leave them loose for the time being. All right, I'm gonna actually just snug those down a tiny bit. Let's go ahead. Now the first thing we're gonna wanna do is, my bike has a kicker on it, so I have the luxury of rotating the motor with the kicker. If you don't have a kicker on your bike, you can put your bike in the fourth gear by lifting the rear tire off the ground and rotating it forward, clicking it back through gears. And once it's in fourth gear, the motor will rotate the easiest. You can also take your spark plugs out if you want to lose the compression, so it'll make your motor rotate a little bit easier. What I'm going to do is rotate my motor so that the lobes on the end of the cam come up to the point where they're on the larger side of the cam lobe that's going to open up your breaker here.
This little rotor here that spins and opens and closes your points breaker there, it has a big side on it, which is the side that it's on right now, and it has a small side. So when it spins, the big side fires one cylinder and the small side fires the other cylinder. So what you want to do is you want to take your feeler gauges, and we're going to set this opening here to 0.018. So the way that you set this here is you loosen this guy. And what I'm going to do is you can open and close it. And if you close it, and if you're using, if you have points that are actually used, what I like to do first is close it, open this guy up with just my finger, put a lightweight piece of sandpaper in there, and you sand it. And that just makes sure that your contacts are clean. So what you do is keep that loose, well, just a little bit snug, actually, not super loose. And you want to open it until your feeler gauge just registered 0.018. So now what you want to do is, I got my 18 thousandths, it's got a little bit of drag on the points. When you go to tighten this back down, a lot of times what it does is you might have been good on your 18 thousandths, and then when you tighten this screw back down, it closes up a little bit. Just be aware of that and check it after you tighten it. And then what you want to do is, once you have it and you're pretty confident that you have your 18 thousandths in there as close as you can get it, rotate your motor 180 degrees until this lobe that's going to be on the bottom will be on the top. It's a smaller lobe. And then recheck that you're at 18 thousandths. You want to be as close as possible on both sides. It'll just make your motor run best. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to get the front intake cylinder up on its compression stroke. The way to know that you're there is we want to do is collapse our pushrod tube. The way you can do that is by popping this sucker out. You push down on here and pop this guy out of there. We're going to lift this up. So this is your front intake valve. When the lifter comes up, and then as the lifter goes down, we're going to want... that's where you're gonna wanna stop the motor. So I'm gonna start pushing the bike through. We'll go all the way, come on. All right. So here comes the lifter pushing it up. Now it's gonna come back down. And when it comes all the way back down, which is there, now I know my front cylinder is on compression stroke. So you can put that down, and we're going to go over to the other side of the motor. So this is your timing hole plug here. You're going to use a 3/8 inch Allen to bust it loose. I already did. Harley kind of did a weird thing where different years had different top dead center marks. What you can do is bump your kicker over very slowly, and we'll do that here in a second. We're looking for the TDC mark on our flywheel. Up through early 1980, they have a small drilled dot low in the timing hole for the TDC mark and a vertical line for the advance mark. After early 1980, the factory changed the TDC mark to the vertical line. We're looking for TDC, so position it so it's just inside the edge of the timing hole. You want the back edge of the TDC mark touching the back edge of the timing hole. So we're gonna rotate the motor here in a second, and then I'll turn the camera back on. So you can see maybe in the camera here that I've got a slash here, the thick line that's in the back of the hole here. That's my TDC mark, because mine's an 83. 70 through early 80 will have a dot drilled low on the timing flywheels there for the timing hole. So now that I know that I'm in TDC, because I rotated my motor around until that little slash mark there is just on the back edge of the timing hole. So we have our TDC mark lined up in our timing hole. I put the timing hole plug back in. I also took my pushrod cover and reattached that.
Now what you're gonna need to do is you hook up your 12 volt switch source here. It goes through the bottom and I'll hook that up. And what it does is it goes in the same place and it has to be touching where your condenser is. And then what you do is you loosen your two locking screws here for your points plate and you rotate it all the way counterclockwise. So I'm gonna hook up this lead here and then what we're gonna need is a test light. All right, so I got my test light here. One side's hooked to ground and one side you can see I got my alligator clip there hooked right onto the power side. I got my points plate rotated all the way counterclockwise and what I'm gonna start doing is I'm just gonna start moving the points plate clockwise and as soon as it starts to register 12 volts, right about there, your points are just opening, even though you can't even really see it with the eye, your points are just opening. And as soon as you get it there, I would suggest going back and forth a few times so you just can get it nice and close as possible. What you're going to want to do then is just tighten down and then you are all set. That is static timing. All right, motor's cold. Let's see if we can get it to kick over.